It's happening.
Or is it?
Chase the Mind Sculptor. I have not yet had a chance to play that card. Chase is pretty good. You like... Can I please resize the window matching on land? What else though? Liliana, Colonnade, Skull Clamp. Nothing really first pickable, right? Goblin Guide, go aggro. Boring. What do we have to go with our chase? Ancestral, Urza, Teferi. Those are some good hits. I kinda wanna go Teferi. Maybe we can do a thing. Good song, by the way. Yeah, Ancestral Vision isn't that high on my list. Recall, obviously. Vision, good, but... As we saw in the previous game, opponent was kinda dead before it even came down. Ugin, Sowa, Seachrom Coast. I wanna do something controlling here. I think Ugin's the pick, he's just so good. Maybe we can ramp into him somehow. He's just like the reset button. The opponent's doing some stuff, you're like, oh, I'm not feeling that opponent. Can you, like, can you take him down? We control, your W control is love, I agree though. Ugin doesn't agree with those if they're already out. But still, if you resolve Ugin, you mostly win anyway. So I've taken 3 Planeswalkers now, we need the support, which we are gonna get very assuredly. Miskalk is great, Solemn is good in a control-y deck. Spellseeker could be good, Karakas is also nice. Doesn't bounce Planeswalkers sadly, I think it's Miskalk though. Well, Solemn to go with Ugin, it's between those two. Dude, I love the song. We just had Miskalk, let's try Solemn. There is a surprising low amount of counter magic in the cube. So, if we wanted to control, it may have been a bad choice, but I also like ramping. Ramping and valuing most fun things. Dude, I have not played any black decks, like, in a while. Are we Armageddoning? There are some good picks here. Another one of the steal your opponent stuff effects. Only good against blue though. I had it in the sideboard earlier. Maybe try to set up a treasure cruise. It is kinda hard though with not too many fetches going around. Ah, let's try it. In a control deck it's gonna be good. Play it like after playing some removal spells. You gotta try something new for our chance change. Okay, we got some options here. Elspeth Conquers Death is like, it removes something and it gets back a Planeswalker. Yeah, that's gotta be the pick. So we get some lootings, discard one of our Planeswalkers and then get it back. I'm really loving that. Uro. Narset. Narset and try to get some draw 7 effects. Baleful Strix is also big love. I want every blue card in this pack. Let's go with Narset so we don't have to splash yet. Prison Warrior sounds dope. That was also a consideration. It was in the Elspeth Conquers Death pack, right? Yeah, Prison Warrior is also good. Don't worry, I'm here. Premium removal spell. Sharktiphone, dude, control is so open, what the hell? Even blue-white tempo is open, which I like more, but I've done it before. I guess I'm gonna try out Sharktiphone, I haven't had a chance to play it yet. There are so many things you wanna do in this cube. Colonnade wield, bro. Control is super open. Maybe should I even take in the miscalculation? What's a hero? Land tax, serpent, foundry. I mean, what's is good, but better in a artifacty deck. Forget some mana rocks though. Serpent is also nice. Goes in the Urza deck. Land tax, I don't know. It's good. I'm not feeling the Urza. Maybe we'll splash red at some point. O-ring seems meh to me. It's good, but don't know about this. Yeah, tempo, like a white aggro slash tempo deck is also very open. Let's try that though. Oh, Armageddon came back. I'm gonna take Helix, so. Goes with the Sacred Foundry. It's also a sideboard card for me. Not every deck is aggressive in the cube. Why did my stuff move? Did anyone see that or am I going crazy? Predator is a nice one. If we splash green. Thalia, not really for us. Dude, the white creature deck is always open as well. Oh, Frost Titan. Ponder. I think we kinda need Ponder to go with the treasure cruise and everything. Yeah, you can always find more win conditions for your control decks. We don't need the Frost Titan. Now we want some fetch lands to go with the Ponder and okay, with Preordain, control magic, crazies. Yeah, also library though. I think we have to play library. It's so good in a control deck. Man, I want some fetch lands now. I think I haven't passed any in my colors. Could be wrong. Already, deck's looking kinda sweet to me. But we need more counter magic and answers. The control magic would have been good. Treachery. Force, of course. JVP is kinda nice with all of the, like, discard a Planeswalker and then reanimate it with Elspeth Conquers Death. Yes, please. And then flashback some Force Signet, Thief of Sanity. Portal is repeatable card advantage. I think we need some counter magic. Some ramp. Battle Skull is also very nice. Stabilize the game. This is kinda hard pick. We're not really Emery-ing. But I think the Dynamo. Let's take Battle Skull. Wrath of God can be good with this deck, yes, yes, I'm feeling it. Fact of Fiction is also a nice one, but yeah, this is a nice reset button for like aggressive decks or rampy mana dorky decks. Frantic Surge could be good in this deck. That's Ajani is also nice. Yeah, we support the Red Splash, maybe. Let's find some fetches to fetch this Sacred Foundry. Mindslaver, you say? Field of Ruin. It's so slow though. Relic Water is good. Let's take Absent. It's an answer to basically anything. I don't think the Preordain is gonna wheel, even though it would be nice. Next pack, get me some Flooded Strands or something. Oh, Frost Titan is back. Yeah, not really feeling the mana tithe. Library is the perfect card to go with the Force of Negation. Lose 2, but draw 2 every turn. And even if you draw it later in the game, it's still a land that makes mana. These lands are awesome. Is it better than control magic? Huh. Yeah, let's take the land. Having lands that do stuff is underrated. Maybe not, but it's super good. Academy, in case we get more mana, or more mana rocks. It's not good if you have like one artifact. Ah, that's good. More answers. Emery, we may be doing artifact things, but probably not. We've passed like Urza and stuff. But then the people take Urza but don't want Emery, what? Like, why? Any white or red fetch would be awesome. Because Achani is very good. Ah, whatever. Not playing these cards. Alright, fresh pack. Gideon Jura is awesome. Soul Ring, Skyclave. Remand Opposition. We're not oppositioning, even though it's busted. We just gotta take Soul Ring, it's so good. Maybe we will do artifacty stuff after all. Academy. We'll see. What I want most of all is fetch lands. Soul Ring's too good to pass, even though I want multiple cards from that pack. We got our force, we also get Teferi, Glen Elendra. Like what? It's crazy, dude. I don't know what I wanna take. Which one is gonna wheel of these? I want Force of Will, I think. Stop them from doing busted stuff as much as possible. Maybe we'll Glen or Teferi. And then we have ways to refill our hand after the opponent, after spending multiple cards on stopping them from doing stuff. We are really not seeing any fetch lands, are we? Time Warp is very good with when you have some Planeswalkers out. We have a few. Impulse is like fine. We have another Mana Rock. Still not feeling Academy. Said in my previous deck, I really wanted it. Let's try Time Warp. Gearhulk, Baneslayer, Academy Ruins. Also not really for us. Gearhulk's nice. Deck Faden though. Yeah, let's play that. Yeah, he's extremely good. Man, our fixing though. We haven't seen anything. The fixing is gonna be hard in this deck. This doubles up any spell. Okay, we don't really have anything to go with that. Yeah, let's take a ramp. Artifact. That's fixing. Yeah, that's cool. Maze of Eth. That was a consideration. I wasn't looking at it. Your chat message came in a bit late. You could try refreshing your browser because sometimes you're just delayed a lot. Cryptic or Treachery? Both of those are crazy good. I think I want more counter magic. Ah, Treachery though. Untap your lands and steal a creature. Ah, I wanna play Cryptic. Yeah, maybe I should have just taken Maze. It's like, it's not a land, it's a spell, but it's a free removal spell. It's not good in every matchup. So, with this configuration, we can like... Well, in theory, we can turn 2 Power Stone. What does Power Stone ramp me into? Not really too much. Whoops. Maybe this isn't even main deck. This is exactly 23 spells. Ah, no fetch lands ever. Not a lot here for me. Don't think I'm playing any of these cards. I don't have the fixing for Leovold, even though he's good. Also not for Scholar. None of the pure no metal worker. I could have maybe had a sick artifact deck in this draft. But I just did it. Or I could be good actually. I only see him as a storm card, but he's like... Makes your spells cheaper and loots when you... do the opposition came back. I think it's Gideon though. We are a planeswalker heavy deck with time warp and everything. I think this is a sideboard card maybe. I mean it's slow and shuts down a lot of stuff, so I don't know. Ugin kills small things. I think you still play him. Maybe not. 8 mana is much. Huh. Like Ugin also would wipe a lot of my things. I love where this deck went, by the way. Teferi also. Wow. Yeah, I like Teferi more than Luna. This looks awesome. Maybe Ugin is an out for now. Like, we're not ramping hard. With only 3 ramp spells. Better Skull against aggressive decks. This is now a deck. Looks cool to me. Thassa's Oracle. Ooh, Soulfire Grandmaster. Theoretically combos with a Time Warp, but you need like 9 mana. Then it's infinite. We don't have Time Walk. And otherwise it's just a 2-2 lifelink. Let's take the Mana Rock. Good thing to play on turn 2. Wow, I'm getting hooked up. Gearhulk to flashback a counterspell. The Maze also came back. Nice, no one wants it. Elish, no Inkwell. Yeah, oops. I accidentally double clicked, but... That's fine. Wow, this is looking fun. Gonna be hard to find some cards here. So I'm grouping this by playing it on turn 2 or being a reactionable card. Maybe Treasure Cruise since you have no fetches. Yeah, I do have though. What? I have a Ponder, I have Chase who loots me, I have Baral who loots me sometimes. Whoops, that's not what I wanted. What did I just remove? The Signet. Let's see. Shark Typhoon cycles on turn whatever. Three mana planeswalkers in this deck is amazing. Wow, we have so many planeswalkers, I love it. Yeah, I'm not sure about this treasure cruise because we're gonna have a lot of value on the battlefield anyway. We can play it against like control heavy decks. This deck's looking super fun. This is free. Also a Wrath of God in case the opponent's overwhelming us. I'm actually not sure about Maze of Ith in the main deck. It would be a spell. I'm gonna play it against like creature-y decks. For which I have a lot of sideboard cards. Is the Baral even an in? I have like, what, 2 counter, 3 counter magic cards. I don't have a lot of instants that he makes cheaper. So we can... Okay, this is 23. Maybe this deck doesn't do too much broken stuff, or not enough broken stuff for Vintage Cube. But at least it has the two forces to stop the opponents. Would have liked to pick up a Daze. More good mana. We have some. Colonnades, awesome. We only have two things that make red for two red spells. I think this is how we're gonna run it. How much white do we need? Double white, double white, double white, double white. This is kinda hard. But we kinda need those cards, right? We have a lot of card draw though. If we put in one mountain, do we need two? We do want to find red sources for these. But we can play them a little bit later. Huh. We could cut the red. But no, I love both of these cards a lot. 174 doesn't actually sound horrible to me. Yeah, I guess this is how we're gonna play it. It's torrential good enough. Yeah, he's pretty strong. Well, how many instants do we have though? Maybe he's just bad in this deck. We have Cryptic, Force and Force. So sometimes he doesn't do enough and he's a 6 drop. Ah, oh, that's also not very good. Huh. Maybe, well, Elishnon. We don't have a lot of creatures, so it's only good against the opponent's stuff. Maybe just Ubin, he's so strong. Or the Power Stone, have more mana. Doesn't fix though. Wraith's Feathers is also in consideration. Let's go with that. It disables anything. Alright. Let's go. It's round one of my fourth Vintage Cube draft of the night. I promise it's gonna be the last one. I'll be right back. Well, no match yet. Interesting. There we go. With the control heavy deck with like 17 planeswalkers in the main deck. More like 8 or something, but it's a lot. Opponent. Why do I every time have to resize my window? Magic Online, please. Alright, we are on the play against Lawyer78. What's up? Yeah, that seems like a keep to me. It's slow, but it can come back, so yeah. Guess you can play that on the play. Don't mind me just planing my planes. island. Should we make them think we're mono white? Well, now I can't play Narset next turn, but I would play with the fairy probably. Didn't get unfair stuff for Narset, sadly. Question is, do I immediately downtick so I never lose out on my value if this resolves? Alright, straight up counterspell. We have the control mirror. Interesting. Now I wanna defend my red mana. To steal that! Come on, red mana! Alright. Well, okay. Do I need... Alright, this is a keep. Can play Chalice now. They removed the zero option. That's cool. So you can't accidentally just cast it without multi-kicker. Or at least it's harder to do that. There's maybe an Emiria's Call game where we get to cast it. We have some answers. We need the opponent to play some cards. Maybe I have too few red sources in the deck. I don't wanna play too many mountains, so... JC boy. We can ECD that though and then maybe reanimate it even. If they don't have a force. It's the Chase Mirror. I love it. Why do I have to queue into the control mirror? I wanna control something. It's cool though. No force please, no days. One time, okay. That's cool. Next turn, the non-creature spells cost two more, and then I get something back, if it survives. Otherwise it's still a good trade. Oh, this gets exiled though. So I can, well, I can get Teferi back. That's also something. I'm drawing an island, so I'm not doing too much here for a while. Oh, they're an artifact, or at least a little bit. Yeah, the blue artifact deck. I see. What are you doing, opponent? Bribery? Do I have any creatures? Not many. Frost Titan. Oh, that's pretty good. I do have an answer though, at least. I have Frost Titan and Solemn, and that's it. So if I target that, I have to pay two more. So maybe I just Wrath it. I can bounce it to my own hand though next turn. When I get back to Teferi. Let's go with that plan. Let's save Emiria's Call. Probably take a hit here from Frosty and see what they follow it up with. Oh, we still have Wrath up, maybe. This is going to be a long one, I can only imagine. Not complaining, but kinda complaining. What a god opponent. I love how Academy is just an island. At least for now. I hope I can get back Metiferi and just bounce that to my own hand. That'd be kinda cool. That's value. A lot of it. Okay, Baral means they can... They must have some counter magic in the deck, some more. Any Final Fantasy VII fans? Let's just draw the card and we don't really need the body. Ooh, library. Now we get back to Teferi, hopefully. Bounce Frost Titan to our own hand, pay 2. Extra loyalty even. Now we could library, that's kinda awesome. Like, we don't need to do anything else here. Bro, I love where this is going. We're gonna draw every card in our deck. Baral coming in hot. We might steal their only artifact making Academy useless. Okay, oh, it's not main phase yet. This was a huge swing, bouncing my own Frost Titan. Time Warp though, basically doesn't do anything, right? Well, Teferi is gonna die, I guess. But it's not like we need that to survive. Alright, what else do you have, opponent? Time Warp was the best play. What do we do next turn? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Not too much. I kinda wanna get Deck Faden down and steal the Signet. Maybe they have counter magic, but... Ooh, a Chani also. Which one is the bait card? Oh, we only have one red now. It's sad. I can play something and then draw a card. Oh, I have 9 cards in hand? Yeah, nice. That's a lot of cards though. Get something counted here. I can only imagine. But 1-for-1 trades on the spot position are pretty okay. Cryptic. Alright. Yeah, that's why they needed to kill Teferi, it makes sense. Opponent's playing a big deck, they still have 33 cards in the library, like what? Guess we draw in case we find a... I didn't save double blue. That's kinda bad. Okay, that's good. We gotta discard something now, I guess it's C-Chrome. Man, my tapping was... I should have played an island and not a... Oh, they're high-tiding? Oh, I should have countered that. I thought it was still my turn, damn it. Exile the Frost Titan that they previously stole. Do you also have Time Spiral though? That would be such a misplay then, not countering the High Tide. Treachery. That's kind of cool. Generates mana on their own creature. Is last card Time Spiral though, or some huge payoff? 16 mana. Blightsteel. We can handle a Blightsteel. That's cool. Now they have no cards. Okay, that went better than it could have gone. Now we strike back. Can't get library going anymore, but whatever. Sorry, opponent, I gotta do this. Sweet Hightide deck. They have all the payoffs and everything. Nice. Let's go to Value Town. I could consider saving up to 7 cards in hand. This game's not over yet, but they have all of the blue stuff. I'm glad I have my forces and everything. Our set is kinda annoying. I'm gonna make some angels, I guess. Achani can actually kill Narset. I might have to do that, maybe. They have a mana leak. I'd be wary of that. So yeah, I can't draw cards here. So I might just kill that and then draw my card. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, perfect. Can still be safe through a mana leak here. Maybe they have mana leak in days. This matchup's kind of a showdown. Well, Mana Leak and Miscalc. Did they play Miscalc yet? No. They can always just draw Time Spiral and turn about. Yeah, I'm gonna just float some mana here then. Okay. That's not a... that doesn't do anything. You would have to turn about me upkeep or something. The Wrath of God is coming out after sideboarding. Oh, did they draw Time Spiral? Oh, Piling Crown, okay. Oh, they have the perfect hide deck. I wouldn't be upset to lose to that. They have everything that Time Spiral deck wants. But if we can beat it, even better. Now we go aggro with the Angel Warriors. I just put that on top. So they can't luck into Time Spiral. Then we cryptic it. Sounds like a plan. Oh, they can bounce it now. That's cool, right? Melee. Yeah, it's okay. So they do draw something. But we can... I guess we let Palingron resolve and counter a potential Time Spiral or something. And Teferi can still handle the 4-5. Dig through time. If I counter that, they can... How much mana does Palingron cost? 7. They can play Palingron on top of their lands. Then they can still, like, the only thing they need is Time Spiral, right? Or they could find Time Spiral and a counter spell here. Counter target spell, draw a card, I guess. Like, it's more likely they find their win conditions off of this than top of the deck. Ooh, we find Shark Typhoon, they're dead, nice. Bro, medics, awesome. Get that on board, opponent. They're not giving up. You gotta appreciate it. Then I just... Okay, they realized they're dead on board, I guess. Alright, we're up against High Tide. I don't really have more counter magic than I already have. I could go more aggressive. Maybe Thalia, but that also is really bad against myself. They have the Blightsteel, so maybe I want Maze. Wrath is coming out. Torrential, because the games tend to go long and I can counter again and have a win condition. Well, we could also take out all the bribery targets, that's kind of fun. Now we only have Jason Solemn. I think that's better. Take out every single creature against the bribery deck. That would be even more fun. That's a keep. It has it even has the white mana here. Yeah, that's actually a perfect hand, I think. And force to counter a potential high tide. Question is actually when the high tide. We might not even counter the High Tide, because then they have mana up. Counter our counter spell. Well, it still fizzles their plan, right? Ooh, We're just chilling here. I'm not a big control player, this is kinda new to me. But this is gonna be a whole bunch of turns passed. With 4 sub we might just slam a chase. What do you do? Vendilion click, huh? Yeah, I have no answers to that. It's pretty good, but it's fine. They probably take off us. Maybe we die here. I couldn't have prevented that, so we must put force to the bottom here, right? That is pretty good, especially in this matchup. Now they have pressure and take our counter magic away. Yeah, you gotta do it that way. We can block the thing though with a 1-1 shark, right? Those flying sharks. But with 4 islands. Okay, they don't have 4 islands, so we're not dying. Yeah, we're trying to trade here with a shark. Okay. Well, we are very soft to a high tide. Port's good in the high tide deck. Wait, they're not porting me? Well, slamming Jason. Well, maybe they must have Cryptic. But I still have to draw it out, I think. I can't just... With this hand, I can't just not do it. Yeah, they must have Cryptic here. Thinking about this. Oh, am I disconnected? It does the whole swirly thingy. That's bad, I think. I hope I'm not disconnected here. Okay. Wait, what's happening? Yeah, they have the Cryptic. Counter bouncy land, okay, yeah, that's pretty good. They're on the high tide plan, this is the best thing they can do to us here. They have everything, dude, they must have been completely open on their table. Finding a counterspell here. Why tap this way then? Because they're just potting us? No? Okay, interesting. Okay, they have the mana leak also, wow. Yeah. Not like I could have prevented that. Now all they need is a high tide and a time spiral, I guess. Emery, okay. What's that milling? An O-Stone and North of Signet. I could just absent it. Yeah, I gotta try to absent the Emery. They can counterspell me, but then I get Teferi down, I guess. So one, either of these is resolving, hopefully. And they have two cards. Oh, High Tide is in the graveyard now, though. That's interesting. Like, now, what is their game plan? How can they get the High Tide back? They must have some way. Have we seen any? Okay, this resolves, so Teferi gets countered. Do we cast him? Good Treasure Cruise, though. To try to find the force or whatever. Do I have any one mana plays I would like to make? Maybe a Ponder. Well, my client's getting unbelievably slow. Are you counterspelling that? No, interesting. Oh, also the Soul Ring into Signet. That's awesome. They have two cards in hand, and High Tide is in the graveyard. I wonder if they can win the game when I have no protection. We need a Snapcaster, High Tide, and then... and then Time Spiral. Emery... yeah, Emery was on top. Turnabout and Forge Master Wield. They have an O-Stone now in the graveyard, which is annoying, so I might have to feather Emery, or to ferry it. Well, I can try both, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I guess I try to Faith Feather first. They still have the counter spell, but they're saving it for the Teferi. I don't want them to get Emery value, because they can then O-Stone me. Yeah, one card in hand is counter spell, which we know about. Which we're gonna draw out here in one way or another. And we have to the Angels to finish the game. They know we have Teferi back from when the Vendilion clicked me. Oh, it resolves. Do I cast Teferi into a counterspell? I don't have to, right? Well, then I can next turn Emiria's Call. It clocked them. Yeah, Teferi is a throwaway here. This gotta get counterspelled. Yeah. It's cool. They have only one card. They can kill me with one card, right? With High Tide in the graveyard. I mean, Time Spiral is a start. They draw seven new. Yeah, that. Oh, that also shuffles Stink Graveyard. I totally missed that one. They must have not found it yet, right? Land End. They have exactly six mana. Okay. Maybe they have it? No, okay. That doesn't do too much. I hope they don't have like... okay, Mana Leak is in the graveyard. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... 6, 7... I get this through a miscalc at least. Now they gotta find their win condition in 2 turns, I guess. Well, if they just Time Spiral, they might find the win, but I guess they don't have it. Man, Magic Online is getting so slow, I gotta restart it after this game.
They found the line.
I actually think the three red sources in the deck are fine. With how many cards it draws. Time Warp. Well, that's pretty good. When you're in this position, that's really good. If I could flash it back somehow, I would have to win already. Oh, choose target player. Yeah, me please. Oh man, feels like the client is dying. If I had my mainland, I would have the win. There it is. If the opponent kills me next turn, that's incredibly ironic then. Let's see if they have it. Alright, opponent, do your worst. Two cards. Two random cards. Don't... Okay. If they had time spiral and then spin into high tide, they would probably win. Whew. That was crazy. I have to restart Magic Online, it's getting so slow. After 7 hours of gameplay, it must have some, like, memory leaks or whatnot. 1-0, up 1-0 with the control deck, though. Loading Magic Online, hell yeah, you are. Okay, where is my league? Play match. There we go. Here be. We timed out. Two more matches, then I swear I will quit. This is my fourth draft. But it's just too much fun. We are up on the play against the Lego Kid. What's up? The one lander. Actually, the two lander with Ponder. Yeah, that's a keep. That's the benefit of the blue decks. And Chase as a looter. Desperate loot house chase. Let's just ponder our existence here. Ooh, yeah, that's a keep. That's awesome. Let's draw the island. And then the soul ring, or other way, it doesn't matter. Man, soul ring. Pretty good card. Pretty messed up card. Kirby. Don't counter me, bro. Alright. I love not having to do the signature shenanigans. Lego Kid says good luck, have fun. You too, my friend. Twilight Oatmeal, Kirby's Oatmeal. Alright, maybe we spin into an island to have Cryptic up or a red source. There is my red source. Kirby, Deck's pretty good, especially in combination with Chase. We can flip next turn if two Planeswalkers down. They're thinking about it? Alright, we're getting countered, I guess. Maybe it's Miskelk, I have a mana floating. That would be so funny. Please do it. Come on. They realized though. They stopped paying costs. No, it's mana leak. Alright, deck fading down. Guess I'm fan trading one for one with deck faden. I'm not using my mana here. That's fine. The song is incredibly stupid. Which is why I love it. Shoutouts to my friend Nuplo for making me some vanilla Kipferl. Just in case they counter this, I'm gonna wait on Chase, because then he flips. Makes sense, right? Yeah, cooking's the best way, do you know her? Wait, do I know your IRL? I always forget the Twitch usernames. Not really feeling the library this game. And I think I'm saving that as a spell. Don't need more lands right now. We played each other at FNM some time ago. If you mind sharing what's your name, you don't have to, of course. We have two Planeswalkers on the battlefield versus Blast Zone. What are you doing? Oh, they are tapping the land though. Okay, that's good. Pressure for the Planeswalker. Doesn't kill him though. I can sneakily block the Bratzen Borrower with a shark, that's kinda nice. I can also lock it down, but I think I'm locking down a land again. John is pretty annoying. Destroy all lands target player controls. Let's do that. Shouldn't have played the land. Yeah, that was a mistake. Well, we'll find our island, whatever. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mana. I can make a 4-4 shark, that's pretty good. We're really doing the super annoying control stuff here. It's Thomas. I played Moxless Affinity 4 years ago. Oh, nice. Welcome. Of course I know you. Shark time. Don't forget to put all your mana into that. Shark Typhoon is a messed up card. Well, it's a good card. And they're not beating my Planeswalkers, which is awesome. Oh, it's time to spin the top 100 million times. Hey, hey!
Do I look like I know what a JPEG is? I just want a picture of a goddamn hot dog.
Phantasmal image my shark. Alright, you got it. I can just kill that with Ajani. But can I flashback here? Only the Ponda. Still pretty good. Can also kill it with Cryptic. Is that better? Kinda wanna lock down the blast zone. Does he have an ultimate? Whenever you cast a spell, they mill 5. We might kill them with that actually. Did I just play the island? Oh, okay, at least I can play Cryptic now. Maybe they play a spell and I can kill the shark with Cryptic. Otherwise I just trade, I guess. I don't need mine. Just heal to that. Yeah, I kinda wanna lock down the looter so they can't loot. And my planeswalkers don't take damage. But it was also a consideration. Just play a spell so I get my 2-for-1. Bribery. I have a Frost Titan. Yeah, let's counter that. Counter a spell, bouncy thing. Bribery is not that good versus me, and now that I know, I will just side out my Titan again. This song is so funny. Narset, or just make some angels. That's Narset, because we can. I wanna have all the planeswalkers down. Now the looter isn't very good anymore. Oh, also they have to attack us so they can loot anyway. What does Narset give me? Ooh. I'd take the first to be safe. We can't force here. Okay, they just concede. GG. We control them hard. Loving it. Titan comes out against the bribery deck. We have two creatures now, Chase and Solemn. We could actually take them out to totally fizzle the bribery, which is kind of funny. Let's do that. These cards are good, but we have other good cards. What's up, Wind Cubes? What's up, Wobble? I'm having a ton of fun here. Absolute banger incoming. Like, what's the opponent's deck doing, really? Bribery. Do I want my Power Stone? It's good. Instead of Solemn. What's better, Ugin or Treasure Cruise? I think it's Cruise. Cruise instead of Chase. Now we have zero creatures. I hope they bribery me. I played in a mid-tier tournament earlier. Did you win? I thought your character was a top tier. Ooh, the library draw. Let's go. The mid tier was strict. It went with like the 2015 tier list, now strength target, whereas it's Mario. So Doc is higher than that, I think. Red. I see, what did you play then? Samus? No, she's also higher. Luigi? No, Luigi's also higher than Mario, right? He's the worst of the brothers in that tier list. Red. Rotting Regisaur. How about we lock that down and they still have to discard every turn? How does that sound, guys? We could also just bounce it here to draw off of Library again and lock it down next turn. Actually, we gotta draw first. Lost my run one, I wanna torment with Mario. Dude, that's awesome. Congrats. Could I have done this differently that I've blew up? No, not really, right? If Regisaur was their best play, I'm gonna put it on top. And then we can Faith's Feathers it while still drawing the library card. I hope my neighbors like this music, if you know what I'm saying. Five. Dude, the library draw is insane sometimes. Oh, you're winning in MTG. Yeah, I win more in MTG than I win in Smash, honestly. Actually, I'm not sure if that's true. I'm a 2-1-er. Yeah, I have a 66% win rate today. Exactly. Which kinda similar to Smash. In Smash a loss just hurts more because you always have control over everything. In Magic you just say, ah, it was the variance that killed me. How do you like that opponent? Had a lead in Grand Finals, was up to 1 and then SD twice on Jungle Champs. Was it a Rishi's Jungle Champ tournament? This is so stupid. I love it. Yawgmoth. Which one of my things should I use? I kinda just wanna bounce it with Chase. I should've played the Tapland then though. Does that change anything? Ajani doesn't kill him. Well, I can ponder. Those are some good ones. Man, I'm usually not the control player, but this is so much fun right now. Like, they're not doing anything and I always have 7 cards in hand.
Amadeus, Amadeus, Amadeus.
They should sack the creature though, before this happens. Sideways cards, PogChamp! No wait, Craigasm! Well, you can compare it with Luigi when he does side B. And he's in landing leg, he's sideways like the magic cards here. And he can't do anything when he's sideways like that. And the cards, they work the same way. Too many cards! most memorable thing about your experience service cards is how you survived quicksand. I did. It was at the time where there was a flood in Austria in 2014, I think it was, or 2012 or something. And then the flood was gone, leaving a whole lot of mud around in the woods next to the river Danube. And I was just taking a walk in the morning after maybe being a little bit drunk. And I almost sank in the mud / quicksand combination. Didn't know. Oh, they found something they like? I feel like I can handle anything at this position. Bribery! Bribery! We did it! Yes! Got him! Oh my god, this is too much fun! Oh god, let's draw a card. Embartia's ghoul. The creature that is not a creature. I'd love to see the look on their face right now. Yeah, dude, me too. GG's. Oh man. Holy shit. I didn't imagine playing control could be that much fun. Maybe I'll try it in constructed once. Man, I wanted to do my sweet control stuff. Should I just be bribery proof in general? Take out frost titties? Like, when you're playing the control deck, it doesn't really matter what your win conditions are, right? The other two creatures aren't devastating when they find it with the bribery. Alright, we are in the finals against Carmelo Mengexp. What's up? Two-headed giant 2-0 against Carmelo Mengexp. Carmelo Mengexp. Carmelo Mengexp. Alright, what's with this hand? It's very slow. Really slow. It does have lands though. Ah, let's keep it. We will draw some spells. You never know what's gonna happen in Vintage Cube though. They might be on some super fast strategy and we die. Carmelo Meng XP. Yeah. Makes sense, right? Okay, they're just pondering their existence. Seems cool to me. Let's draw a Sol Ring. Sol Ring. String. No, they have a mox. Okay. Okay, we at least also have a piece of ramp. Now we have all of our colors. I hope they are control-y and not like tinker me here or something. It would be stone cold to tinker. I think you should loot us on purpose unintentionally. Can I look at my deck here somewhere? I guess it's sideboarding.
And what are you dressed as?
Pinocchio.
Pinocchio? You don't have a nose.
Collective Brutality. Ah, that's not too scary. They might be reanimating though. We can handle... Okay, they can discard... That's pretty good. They can discard our Wrath and reanimate Battlesphere next turn. Whew, this is gonna be hard. Not impossible, but hard. What are your top 3 stocks for 2021? Do you remember when Mango 3 stocked Zane? That was pretty neat. What are yours? Mango, the fruit, the orange slash yellow slash red slash pink fruit. Do we have another answer to that? Presumably, Damas, he was asking for S-Fed. Satisfied? S-Fed-tisfied? I mean, if they have nothing else, they only have 2 more cards, maybe we can come back from this somehow. But this is a lot of damage coming in. Oh shit, I did it wrong again. Oh god. Do you own any Tesla? Tesla coils? We can target next turn, but we might... Well, we only take 4 here. Then they have the mirrors. Maybe we can make this work somehow. Do you own any S-Fed? Asking the real questions here now. Do you? Poor Gozu. I hope they have nothing else. Tesla coils best response. I think they are talking about the stock market. Like, stonks. But I'm not entirely sure, honestly. Actually, we can giddy and kill the battle sphere. They know we have it, so... I'm now gonna just sit here and stare at you for a second. Stonks. Yes, please draw me a card. I'm so sad my one answer to the board is gone. But 4-1-1s may be beatable. No counter magic. They have a counter, don't they? No? Okay. Alright, you have 4-1-1s. How is this gonna play out? They are pretty good against my planeswalkers, which is super annoying. I can play Mirror's Call though. Make 2 4-4s. Next turn. What's this? Like a Phrenic Surge? Snappy boy. For no value. Okay. I mean, I'm at 14. This is gonna be scary. But they gotta kill... They just gotta kill Gideon Jura. Wait, why did they do that end step? They could have... Do they have another reanimation target? Then I should have done the fairy thing. They must have another reanimation spell, otherwise this makes zero sense to me. How do you go into the MTG category on Twitch and then ask about top 5 stocks? No, they said top 3 stocks. I do like it when same 3 stocks Mango. No more reanimation spells, opponent. Like, maybe they just needed to get Gideon down here, but... Why the end step snappy? What is this? A Liliana that reanimates something? I'm scared. Okay, another... Ugh! That one discard on Wrath of God was too good. Yeah, I should have done it put it into their library, but how would I have known, right? And now they have four Mew again. Well, I could have anticipated a second reanimation spell from the reanimator deck. Now I draw force. Come on, please. Stock market expert. I'm pretty dead here. They know I have this, so might as well play it and see what happens. I actually own some S-Feds, yeah. I'm going to 2 here. I can't come back from this, can I, with what I have? Or they killed the fairy and I'm going to 3. Even with Faith's feathers, it means I'm dead. You can always hope the opponent misplays, maybe. That brutality was so brutal, as you say. Because it's my one sweeper and I had to have it in the hand, didn't I? Not dead yet, come on. I don't think there's a series of draws that gets me out, but well, who knows, you know. You got me with your reanimation. How do I stop that? Predator, but I have no fixing. Elish Norn. If I get it in the graveyard for Exhume, that would be kind of funny. We have some removal and some counters, so we just kinda got unlucky here. Hogan doesn't really help, I guess. Mace of Eth, not really also. I guess the reanimator deck, it's not come into a time warp situation. That only takes my graveyard, so no. Elish Norn would have saved me this game. Guess we keep it. Hope we don't get Wrath discarded again. Like, brutality. Getting your thing in the graveyard and discarding my Wrath was just way too good. They multi 5 here. So that's what combo decks do, right? They mulligan a lot. They're thinking about it now, what to put away. Puts 2 cards on the bottom and begins the game with 5 in hand. We're just pondering here. Maybe find a mana rock or something. This is a shuffle. That's why Ponder is a good card, I guess. Force that we can't cast ever. Well, not right now. It's gonna be good eventually. They're down to 5, so I hope they're not too on the crazy reanimation draw this time. Five. And Tomb, holy shit, they are doing it. Man, I mean, yeah, they multi 5 and... Okay, Iona shuts down the white side of my deck when it's out. Ugh, and no blue cards for the Force. No. We have odds against Iona, but it's gonna be hard. Why don't I have a blue card? Don't do it, opponent. If Chris is 5, minus 1, then Chris 1 is 6, minus 1, and 5, so his maximum strength for confirmed Illuminati squared plus 2 is 5. Chase, off the top one time, please. Chase! Ah. Wait, where's my land? Oh, I don't have any more land. Oh, man. Opponents, the fun police. This is so sad. Where is my land? Yeah, we're dead. There is a incredibly tiny chance to come back in this game. Eternal 2-1-er today. But this is an instance where I can kinda say Variance killed me. Maybe I should have mulliganed this hand though. Oh no, did I have 6? I wanted to counter something. Damn it. Oh, I didn't even realize they aimed the turret at me earlier. Right? That's where my lens went. Man. Well, it's time to end the stream anyway. My brain's not working anymore. Yeah, I'm dead. GG's. That was fun. And I'm at the exact same point where I started. I went 2-1 four times in a row. Keeping up the 66% win rate, which is good because you get your entrance feedback. I'm back to where I started with my play points. So I get to entertain all you guys for free, basically, with this record. Alright, we're gonna call it a night now. I've been streaming for 7 hours and 28 minutes. It's kinda long. We're gonna raid someone, so stay with me for a minute. It's 3 channel points. 7... what? Yep. You heard right. This is not all night, that's true, that was a lie. I gotta admit to that. Let's raid some magic stream who also does Vintage Cube. Some random stream, I guess. Alright, say hi to me for Squad Chief. Who's Vintage Cubing. And see you, I think, tomorrow. Good night, everybody. Alright, before we end it, treasure chest opening. Open one of these. What is it? 5 play points, faded teeth. I want that. I want to play black-white smallpox in modern. Alright, now we're really out. Good night, bro.